Okay, here we are in Voltmeter Challenge. Today we're going to look at shorts and opens one. We're going to look at a unit that has three different modules in it, and those modules could either be shorted or they could have open circuits. We're going to use the voltmeter to find those problems. So read the overview, get a basic understanding of what's going on and what the possible problems could be and what they might look like. Essentially, what you have down here in the circuit schematic shows us we have a battery that is supplying three uniform modules. Those modules consist of a parallel structured resistor and capacitor, and they are protected by a fuse that's in here. So potential problems, we could have a blown fuse, which isn't open in this series circuit. And so we will see all the source voltage at that fuse area. We could have a situation where our resistor has burned out and it is open, in which case the whole module will behave like it's open because the capacitor doesn't allow current to pass through the module itself in this DC circuit. Or we could have a situation where the capacitor is shorted. And when the capacitor is shorted, we're also bypassing the resistor. So we're shorting out the entire module here. And what we're going to see if that happens is our load drop at our other two modules will be a little higher than the normal voltage operation. When we think about our normal voltage operation, if we had a 12-volt car battery supplying this, each of these modules are identical. So one third of the voltage drop will be found at each module. So of 12 volts, it's going to be approximately a 4-volt drop at each module in a normal voltage operation. If one of these were shorted, what we would see is about a 6-volt drop at the other two modules because a shorted module doesn't see any load voltage on it. So let's begin this and see what happens. So when we look at this circuit, here it is. Here's our 12-volt battery. Actually, 12.588 is our source voltage. These are our three modules, as you see, wound in series and protected by the fuse. And these are contact points where we can check our circuit. Before you get in there, just take note of some basic directions here. The black probe is going to stay fixed. We can't move that. We're going to be moving the red probe around the circuit. Let's also look at the circuit parameters. Although the specific details or values of our resistor and capacitor aren't truly important, it is important to note that each one of these modules, it's identical in terms of its setup. And because they're each 2-ohm, 2 microfarad capacitors in there, basically each module, we can kind of treat them like a 2-ohm voltage drop within here. And remember, if we have a 12-volt battery or a little 12-plus, we're going to see approximately a 4-plus voltage drop in a normal circuit operation at each of these modules. And the fuse itself is also going to have its own voltage drop. Not a very high one, but there will be a very small, probably 0.2 voltage drop that we see at a normal fuse operation. Okay, so when approaching this problem, let's consider the possibilities. We could have a blown fuse, we could have an open module, one of the modules open, or one of the modules could be shorted, or we could just be seeing a situation that is normal operation. Know your source voltage going into this, and consider what is between the probes as you probe the circuit. In this case, our negative probe on our meter is going to stay put, and so we're going to isolate and narrow what's between the probes. So let's begin moving the probe around. We do not have to go to this terminal because the red wire is not one of our possibilities here. So let's get on the other side of the fuse and see what happens. So coming to the other side of the fuse, I'm still pretty much at the source voltage of 12.5. There was maybe a little drop that was going on there. Let's come on the other side of module 3 and see what kind of change occurs then. So coming over here, we see that we stopped down to 6 volts. So I know right away that current is flowing and that module 3 does have a load drop, but it's not my expected load drop around 4 volts. Instead, I see 6 volts. What that's telling me is that either module 1 or module 2 is shorted. So again, thinking about what's between the probes, right now module 1 and 2 are between the probes. Let's see if we can figure out which one is bad. So I'm going to come on this side of module 2, so only module 1 would be between the probes. And what that tells me is module 1, the only thing between the probes, is shorted because I now have 0 volts between my probes here. My load drop consisted of module 2 and module 3. So in this assessment, module 1 is shorted. And so I'll click M1 shorted. I'll grade the item. Now, before I hit grade item, I like to return to my source over here. I grade the item. I'm good. And I can continue. So new problem. We got 12.6 as our source voltage. I'm going to come on the other side of the fuse. I'm still at 12.6. Let's get on the other side of M3. Okay. And I'm still at 12.6. Now, right away, that is a key problem here. I could have an open somewhere in between my probes here. Let's go on the other side of M2. And you see we have 0 volts. Fairly similar to our last setup, but there was no load drop here. So what I'm seeing is what's between my probes. What's between my probes isn't open. All of my source voltage is right here at this open. So M2, in this case, is open. So we're going to come over here and say M2 is open. Grade that item. Hey, I'm good. Now before I hit continue, return my probe to the positive. Hit continue. Okay, and again, we can tackle this problem. This time I'm going to take a slightly different approach without going over here to the fuse. I'll go over here. And it's pretty much the same thing. I got 12.3 as my source voltage. I come over here, 12.3 is still my source voltage. Let's come here. Okay, so I saw a load drop in M3. I know that M1 or M2 is possibly shorted in this situation. So let's get on the other side of M2. Okay, and so we see no change right there. And what that's telling me is M1 is good and M3 is good. M2 is shorted. Just to clarify, notice that on either side here, we're seeing no change. So M2 is shorted. And we'll grade that item and we're good. Before I hit continue, return my probes. So here we have 12.6 volts as our source. Again, I'll take a different strategy. We'll come over here. 12.6, that's fine. Come over here. Oh, I still see 12.6. So I am thinking that we have something in here that's open. Think about what's between my probes. I'll come over here. I'm still seeing 12.6. And you come here. And, you know, there, so we get the 0 as expected because the only thing between my probes is the green wire. But 12.6 is between my probes with only M1 there. So I know that M1 is open in this case. So I click M1 open, grade the item. We're good there. Before we hit continue, return to the positive probe and we'll continue. Now 12.3 is my source voltage. Okay. A new strategy, I can jump right over here to my purple wire. Now, jumping right over there to the purple wire, I'm seeing 0. And if I come to the middle of the circuit here, what's between my probe? I have 0 here. So I'm going to jump back up here to this side of M3. I still have 0. I know my problem lies within the fuse itself. And so within the fuse itself, if I come on this side of the fuse, there, what's between my probes, a blown fuse is between my probes. So I can say that my fuse is blown. Glad we got one of those in there. And let's grade that item. We're good there. Before we hit continue, return to the positive. We go ahead and hit continue. Source voltage, 12.4. So again, I'm going to take a different strategy and jump over here. What's between my probes? Well, 12.4 is between my probes. Something is open. Either M1 or M2 is open. Let's see which one it is. Okay, well, we got a load drop there. So I know that M2 was okay because M2 gave me a low drop. So that tells me I actually had an issue with M3. So when I come back over here, we have 6 volts and 6 volts from M1 and M2, and I see no change up here at M3. So M3 is my issue here. M3 is shorted. All right, so we're going to reset before we hit continue. And I'm starting with a source voltage of 12.5. And again, I'll take this middle strategy here. We'll go right to the center. And we see that we have 0 volts between my probes. That means something back here on this side, M3 or my fuse, is open. So let's go on the other side of M3. I got all my source voltage, M3 is open. So we'll go ahead and say that M3 is open. Okay, and we can continue with that. I think you got the basic gist now. I wasn't able to find any with a perfect normal operation. Maybe I'll give it one more try. We'll reset. And we'll see if we can get one with normal operation. So we start with 12.6 here. Again, take the middle of the road strategy. Nope, we've got something is shorted here. So we know that M3 did drop. My problem is going to lie within M1 or M2. So I come up on this side here. All right, and I see M1's between my probes. So M1 is my shorted component. Say it's shorted. Grade that item. We're good. We can continue on. So before I hit continue, reset my probes. What's my source is 12.4. And again, I'll jump over here. Okay, and I see 6.21. Again, either M1 or M2 is shorted. How do I find out? Get on the other side of M2. Okay, so it looks like M2 is my problem because there was no change. So M1 is normal. M2 is shorted. So click that. Grade the item. We can move on. Looking at our last problem here. 12.4 is my source. Let's come here to the middle. Okay, we got 0, which means that there's a problem over here either with my fuse or with M3. So let's come on the other side of M3. We know it's our fuse. Our fuse is blown. And so we can say our fuse is blown. Grade the item. Good. Continue. Okay, and your exercise is complete. Say okay. I store on the disk, please. Store your grade on disk. Take your certificate and make sure you print this as a PDF. Print this as a PDF. Go through your printer setup. Change this to, we can leave that letter. Change your printer to Adobe PDF and make sure that's set up. Say okay and then hit print. And then this will prompt you to save that file. And this is Shorts and Opens 1. And then you can save that to your downloads or wherever it is that you're going to remember so you can turn that file in. So that's the complete exercise for Shorts and Opens. Good luck on your endeavor as you take it on.